Welcome to my channel MK Mediguide Lectures, learning with artworks like drawing and calligraphy.
In this video lecture, we will discuss about the classifications of neurons. Well, neurons differ in the structure, size, and shape of their cell bodies. And that's why all the neurons are not the same and can be divided on the basis of structure, on the basis of function, and on the basis of myelin sheath presence around the axon of the neuron. On the basis of structural differences, neurons are classified into three major groups, which are multipolar neurons, bipolar neurons, and unipolar neurons. Let's discuss about the multipolar neurons first. Multipolar neurons have many processes arising from their cell bodies. Only one process of each neuron is an axon. The rest are dendrites. Most neurons whose cell bodies lie within the brain or spinal cord is multipolar. The next type is the bipolar neurons. Bi means two, and as I'm drawing the bipolar neuron here, it has only two processes, one arising from each end of the cell body. These processes are structurally similar, but one is an axon and the other is a dendrite. Neurons in specialized parts of the eyes, nose, and ears are bipolar. The third type of neurons on structural basis is the unipolar neurons. Unipolar neurons have a single process extending from the cell body. A short distance from the cell body, this process divides into two branches, which really function as a single axon. One branch is associated with dendrites near a peripheral body part. The other branch enters the brain or spinal cord. The cell bodies of unipolar neurons are found in some of the specialized masses of nervous tissue called ganglia, which are located outside the brain and spinal cord. Besides, neurons also vary in function, and different neurons may conduct impulses into the CNS or conduct impulses from one area of the brain or spinal cord to another, or conduct impulses out of the brain or spinal cord. On the basis of these functional differences, neurons are grouped as the sensory neurons, association neurons, and motor neurons. Let's discuss about the sensory neurons first. Sensory neurons are also known as afferent neurons. Most of the sensory neurons are unipolar and some are bipolar. Sensory neurons conduct impulses from peripheral sensory body parts into the brain or spinal cord. The impulses travel along the sensory neuron axons, which lead to the brain or spinal cord, where other neurons interpret the impulses as a sensation. Moreover, sensory neurons from receptors in the skin, skeletal muscles, in joints are called somatic sensory neurons, and those from receptors in internal organs are called visceral sensory neurons. The second division is the association neurons, which are also known as interneurons, and these are multipolar and lie entirely within the brain and spinal cord. As discussed above, that multipolar neurons have many dendrites in a single axon arising from the cell body. They are associated primarily with linking other neurons. Interneurons direct incoming sensory impulses to appropriate parts of the CNS for processing and interpreting. And other impulses are transferred to motor neurons. Some interneurons in the brain are concerned with thinking, learning, and memory. After this, we have the motor neurons, which are also known as efferent neurons, and they are also multipolar generally. Motor neurons conduct impulses out of the brain or spinal cord to effectors. Motor impulses control muscle contraction and relaxation, and with it, the secretions of glands. Motor neurons linked to skeletal muscles are called somatic motor neurons, and those to smooth muscles, cardiac muscle, and glands are called visceral motor neurons. Sensory and motor neurons make up the peripheral nervous system, and visceral motor neurons form the autonomic nervous system. Besides, neurons can also be divided based on the presence of myelin sheath around the axons of neurons into the myelinated neurons and unmyelinated neurons. The neurons which have the myelin sheath are called the myelinated, like here it is a myelinated neuron that I have drawn here. The neurons supplying the skeletal muscles, that is somatic motor neurons, are myelinated. The unmyelinated neurons don't have a myelin sheath around it. Here it is an unmyelinated neuron. The first ganglionic neurons of the autonomic nervous system are unmyelinated. Besides, what is myelin? If you are confused with it, I have discussed it in the previous video on the neuron structure. You can watch it there. And with this, thanks for watching and support us by subscribing to our channel.